Let's get these clothes off of you. Get you in something a little bit more comfortable there. What do we got going on? Oh. Oh. You dirty girl. What's going on, everybody? I've had time to calm down, took a cold shower to, you know, bring myself back down to earth here because I was on cloud nine when I opened up this box. I've been teasing at this day for a couple videos now, and it's finally here. This is one of the last pieces of the puzzle to get this car ready to go on drag week, and it's here. This is the latest offering from Curry Enterprises. This is their newest version of a Ford 9-inch. How many different versions of a Ford 9-inch can you possibly do? Curry's been around for a very long time. They have big names in the off-road world, pro touring, as well as drag racing. The Ford 9-inch has been around since the dawn of time. This is what makes this one unique. This is a fully fabricated housing, obviously, and it's made entirely out of chromoly. Chromoly, just like in the roll cage world, has the added benefit of allowing you to use a thinner wall thickness without sacrificing any strength, but you get all the added benefits of lighter weight. Couple that with the back bracing here that is fully skeletonized, which is an option as well, and load it with an aluminum center section and the gears of your choice, and you now have a rear axle that is 30 to 40% lighter than any factory style Ford 9-inch housing. This is going to be lighter than the 8.8 that it is replacing, and it's going to be much, much stronger. Let's go the whole walk around on this thing. So when I talked to the guys over at Curry and explained to them what my needs were, they said, look, all we need to know is what bolt pattern that you're gonna run, what brakes you got, what gear sets you need, and what suspension pickup points you got, and then the width of the axle. So you can see by the tape marks over there, I measured the old 8.8 that was in there before I removed it from the car, sent them that, explained to them what I was doing. I said, yo, I want to have instant center brackets on it. I want to have multiple pickup points on the lower control arms to be able to adjust the instant center based upon track conditions or whatever tire, radial or slick, that I want to run. And they took it and they ran with it. And this is what they delivered to me. And it looks absolutely amazing. First things first, it is powder coated, completely clear. It looks bitchin'. I really, really dig it. The uppers here, the upper control arms are mounted on these tabs and it is loaded with their Johnny joints. These are like Heim joints on steroids and they include these bolts with the grease fittings, Zerk fittings already included in them so you can lubricate the uppers. We have a big old fill plug here on the back. No more goofing around with trying to squeeze a bottle of fluid through the pumpkin up front. On the ends here, we got Ford 9-inch big bearing housing ends. I am waiting for the brake caliper brackets from Bear Brakes so I can go ahead and bolt on my Deep Stage brake kit. The axles are 35 spline jobbers with 5/8 inch studs, and I picked up a set of gold anodized 5/8 inch lug nuts. Moving around to the front here, you can see we have a full aluminum strange center section, and this is loaded with a 325 gear set, and they sent me the polished gears. These are going to reduce break-in periods. They're going to reduce the friction as well as the heat that is found in the rear end on this. This is a fully polished gear set. A 1350 chromoly yoke for the drive shaft. The drive shaft is going to have to get shortened up just a little bit, I believe, once we get this up in here and sorted. I can figure out the measurement on it. I pulled the control arms out because I wanted to make sure everything was gonna fit before I was underneath the car wrestling with it, and we are in good shape. One thing I do wanna talk about is the upper control arms here. So when you go to a 9-inch rear end on any Mustang 79 to 04, the Fox Platform, SN95, New Edge, does not matter. Anything that you put a Ford 9-inch into, you're going to have to address the upper control arms. You're either gonna need to modify your current control arms or get a set of upper control arms that are modified already for a Ford 9-inch. There's more than a handful of companies out there that make them. Now, this is not a characteristic or a downfall of the Curry axle. This is a characteristic of all Ford 9-inches. See, the center section here is drastically bigger than what it would be on an 8.8. So when you raise the pumpkin up, you can't just move these pickup points around because that's gonna throw your geometry completely off on your suspension. So these, by design, are gonna get closer to the housing. Well, the control arms themselves, these tabs and the bars and the brackets and all that stuff is gonna get closer to the housing as well. So you need to clearance these a little bit. Quick work with a grinder. We got plenty of room on that now. So All that's left is for me to take this and slide it up underneath the car and start mounting it. This whole housing, this is the cool part. This whole housing is so light, I can literally pick it up with one hand. So this is very easy to wrestle under the car. And then when the time is right, slam the third member into it, slip the shafts in, and this thing is done. It's wrapped up. So, shout out to Curry. Oh, real good at making axles, man. But this granola that they included, it kind of tastes like anyway. Shout out to Curry, Tiny, and John out there, man. Thank you so much for working with me on this project, guys. I'm so stoked to put this thing in the car. I cannot wait to abuse it. And I'm going to try. So I got some work to do, clearly. I'm probably going to call poison control about that granola. And I'm going to put this rear end up underneath the car. So that's it. I got to go. Peace.